始まりは全部ここにある。超短小水次元をもう一人の私に歴史は闇に飲まれて、ただ今先に何があるの、見えるようで見えない真実は、メタメタアラブバドキドキバレラ
This is the Golden Summit.
It's huge.
This is my first time seeing it up close, but it truly is gilded. I wonder if it's completely made out of gold.
It's hard to tell. I've only seen real gold used in overpriced audio cables, so...
Let's hurry inside. I don't know what she's planning, but if it will put Leanbox in danger, then as a CPU, it's my duty to put an end to this.
Whoa! What is this place?
I knew it wasn't a regular tower, but to think it would be like this on the inside.
Estia?
Wait a second, Vert. She's acting kind of... or, well, she seems unlike herself.
Now that you mention it, she does seem... off. Who are you?
Are you Estia?
No.
Oh, she spoke. Then who are you? Huh. Why won't she answer me?
This could possibly be...
Hmm? The one who was texting you?
You've been waiting for us, correct?
Yes.
Oh, she spoke again.
Are you our ally?
Yes.
Then my next question. Estia is here, is she not?
Yes.
I knew it was so. Most likely, she is only capable of responding with yes or no.
Oh, I get it. That's why she didn't respond to my question.
Yes.
Oh, she answered me! Yay!
Who exactly are you, anyway? You look quite similar to Estia, but... Of course, there would be no way you would be able to answer that. Which means... Oh, I know! Are you... Estia?
Yes.
I knew it! But your appearance... A text. That body holds both the souls of Estia and myself within it. Only one of us can be in control at any given time, and that's usually Estia. However, in this tower, I can temporarily materialize as a spirit, so I wanted to come to meet you. That is her message.
Why did you send it by text?
She says, I'm sorry, I have difficulty speaking in front of people. I didn't expect that would be the reason this key person in this final dungeon-esque place is so taciturn.
Estia, were you possibly the sender of the letter that was in Vert's room?
She says, correct. While Estia was asleep, I came forward and sent the letter. I could have used her cell phone, but I was afraid she would find out. So that would seem to be her reason for using a letter. All that I can do is guide you to where Estia is. There isn't much time. The ritual will begin soon. You must hurry.
She disappeared! What was she?
I'm not sure, but we had better move quickly and find where Estia is.
Yay, we won! Level up!
setback.
Here we go! Okay.
Just
this is making me tough.
Leave it to me. Die, loser.
Ouch! Ouch!
Go to hell.
What shall I do?
Here I come.
Sick.
Checkmate.
What shall I do?
I'll be serious. this!
Shall I do?
Still have fear!
Who's next? No one can stand up to my fury.
Thank you.
much longer until we find Esha. All this walking is getting tiring. I think I'm getting thirsty, too. I concur. If I knew we were to walk this much, I would have bought a drink.
Here, take this, then.
Oh, how very kind. Thank you. Huh? It's chill, refreshing, and so easy to drink. How delightful.
I'm glad you liked it. What? What's wrong, Nepgear? Why are you opening and closing your mouth like a fish? Neptune, why are you here? It's been a while, huh? Haven't seen you since Zero Dimension, and I haven't seen Miss Busty over here since that hotel bath.
Huh? You?
Do you know her too, Vert?
Yes. We've met at the hotel's public bath, but I didn't realize she was the other Neptune that you had met.
Surprised, aren't ya?
Well, yes. I can hardly believe it. I couldn't see your face well with all that steam, but you look just like Neptune.
But why are you here? Simple. It's because I'm a member of Affymax, and I'm on a mission to intercept the two of you.
Complicated.
But since that's what's happening, let's just battle it out already. Unfolds.
Going on the offensive! I'll end this with blood art!
Hey!
Bastard!
Ouch! It is my turn.
I rescue you all at once!
Stop!
What shall I do?
Tears of my lovely ladies. I'll finish this with my wind magic sword deck.
Ouch! Stop!
It's my turn. This is my power as a CPU.
To me.
It is my turn.
Ouch! Yeah!
How is this?
I won't hold back! I will show you the power of a CPU! Now the battle truly begins!
I feel strength overflowing.
She really is strong.
Even if she's a different person, she still fights as a Neptune should.
You guys are plenty strong as well. Seriously, I said it already, but you're much stronger than last time, Nepgear. That makes sense, though. You've probably been grinding a lot down here, huh? Nice work.
Speaking with such meta-mannerisms is just like our Neptune as well.
Neptune, please, stand aside! We don't have any time to be wasting in fighting you right now. Besides, I don't even want to fight with you.
Yeah, sure thing.
My job was just to stall you guys. I'm not really trying to defeat you. Besides, you never told me how long I had to stall you for anyway. I probably accomplished my mission by now, I think.
Neptune, what's going on in that brain of yours?
Well, see you again soon, Nepgear, Miss Busty. Neptune, wait!
She left.
Why is she...
I understand that it concerns you, but we must stop Esha before doing anything else.
Yeah, I know, but...
Since you had more of a relationship with her, it's difficult for me to empathize in the same way. In any case, you will have to hold that thought until we locate Esha. I have a feeling the reason Neptune stood in our way is related to her somehow.
So you think Esha is connected to Affymax?
Possibly, if my reasoning is correct anyway. But to confirm this, we must move on ahead. Esha!
You two. I'm surprised you found this place.
What are you planning on doing by gathering all the Rand pigs?
Not concern you.
It does concern us. We've come here because Isha urged us to find you.
I see. That's why there were messages on my cell phone I couldn't recall.
I'll ask you again. What are you planning to accomplish by sacrificing a million Rand pigs?
I guess it's no use. I'll tell you. Now that we know the Demon King was just an illusion, I have run out of options. Before her soul disappears, I must create a vessel for my soul.
What are you getting at?
Then, listen well to the tale of a pitiful girl.
Very well. The truth of our current strife will finally be explained. I will listen to the reason you've persisted for so long.
A long time ago, I was creating a film. I made a mistake that almost took my life.
Huh? I'm sorry. For a moment, I thought you said film. Did you say kiln, as in those industrial ovens?
No. you heard correctly. A film.
When you say film, you're referring to the moving pictures, yes? Not some kind of coding?
Correct.
What do you mean you are making a film? I thought I'd finally hear the truth of our situation, and you begin by telling jokes? Return my excitement this instant.
Please calm down, Vert. It may get more exciting from here on out, so let's listen until the end of the story.
After my failure and I began to die, Isha reached out a helping hand. We weren't particularly close. In fact, it could be said that we were rivals. But even still, she tried to save me. Unfortunately, my body was far too gone for her spells to have effect. Using a forbidden spell, she took my soul from my dying body and transferred it into hers. Ever since then, this body has held the souls of both Isha and me. But human bodies aren't designed to house two souls at once. Naturally, her body couldn't withstand the burden. And although it's been gradual, it's beginning to break.
That's why you wish to obtain a body of your own.
Exactly. I can't let Isha die.
Oh! You're not thinking of creating a new body with those Ranpigs, are you?
That's exactly what I'm thinking. I thought the Demon King's body would satisfy the law of equivalent exchange. But that's not possible now. The Ranpigs will have to do.
I finally understand the reason you were so persistent about the Demon King. And, as I suspected, the soldiers weren't recruited for fighting outside invaders. You just needed them to capture him.
Correct.
And the invaders were created yourself in order to train the soldiers, yes?
You caught on to that plan too, did you?
Of course. Even though the parts were from other nations, they all had a stamp that clearly showed they were from Leanbox.
As expected of a CPU, I suppose. But that doesn't matter now. Gooman! Lady!
You called, Esha?
What's our job this time?
Are the preparations complete?
If you're talking about the Ranpigs, yes. All 1 million are in their cages.
All right. I'll head to the ritual area immediately. Please, deal with these two.
So, we figured us out. Okay. We'll do our best for Isha.
It's in your hands now.
Where are you going?
Whoa there. Step back. You two won't be getting any farther than this.
Then we'll simply pass through by force. Let's go, Nepgear.
Okay.
If my opponents are CPUs, my pectorals can handle this.
I'm not very fond of these hot-blooded types. What shall I do?
Four.
Six.
Four.
Ouch. Prepare yourself. Ouch.
It is my turn. This is also a tactic.
Fulfill my duties as king. I'll finish this with my dark magic sword deck.
Oh,
what shall I do?
One go!
Oh no!
Prepare!
No! Stop! Fix me
you
again!
Guess.
What should I do?
It is my turn. Prepare yourself.
Do you mean to tell me even my highly trained pectorals can't take these attacks?
It's my turn.
You're mine!
Choose you.
Here's that still has spear.
What?
Here I go.
What was that?
Muscles that exceed
not
my
just
muscles.
Can't
hold back.
I won't go easy.
Yeah!
It's my turn.
Give me strength!
No!
Shine my holy sword, Excalibur!
No!
Now then, what shall I do?
Oh!
My muscle!
Come on.
Nephirdam, go!
What is this robot? Stop! No!
All right, the final strike!
Stop!
This is the end.
As though my chest has gotten larger.
I feel strength overflowing.
It seems my caliber has grown larger.
Damn! You've got a great punch. My pectorals are still jiggling.
I'm done as well. You're really strong, Vert.
You two are surely aware of what Esha is attempting to do, yes?
Of course.
Then why do you help her?
That's because Esha is just as precious to us as she is to Esha.
Esha was originally a friend of ours from a long time ago. At first, we were shocked when we discovered her soul was in Esha's body. She was a kind girl, despite her poor social skills, but we never had even heard of someone using a forbidden spell to displace a soul.
It's what Esha truly wanted. So we decided that we'd all live together along with Esha. However, after some time had passed, Esha revealed that a time was coming when her body could no longer hold both of their souls. Since then, we've searched so desperately for a way to save Esha.
And so you've arrived at this method.
That's right. We may not have known her long, but Esha is a part of our family. She was saved purely by the kindness of Esha's heart. That's enough of a reason for us to help, even if we have to do something inhumane.
Well, I don't think you two were very human to begin with.
Don't be so insensitive, Vert. They have such a good, moving story to tell.
I understand why you would support her, but there's something that simply doesn't make sense.
What is it?
How did Esha come to discover that their body would not last?
It is her body, after all. Isn't it natural she would know about her own body the best?
What did Isha have to say about it? It was originally her body, was it not?
Isha said it wasn't true, but Esha insisted that she was just trying to endure the pain.
I see. I have one last question. Who proposed this method of transferring Esha's soul into another vessel, an actual body?
The way to create a new body, using the Demon King, or now using the Ranpigs as substitutes, were all Esha's ideas.
But now that I think of it, it's kind of odd how these ideas seem to have come to her.
Odd? How so?
She often falls asleep while sitting in a chair. Whenever she came up with those ideas Goom Man mentioned, it was always right after she woke.
Esha's a clever kid. She's probably always thinking of crazy ideas, even in her dreams.
Well, it was different with the Ranpigs, though. Someone named Arfor suggested that idea.
Arfor?
That name. It's the same name as the deity of Sin who once terrorized game industry. It's also the same name as the opponent Nepgear battled in Zero Dimension.
That's right. So naturally, we were shocked at the coincidence. But don't worry. She may have bad taste in makeup, but she's definitely a human. Oh, but that girl Neptune who came along with Arfor was very sweet, inside and out.
I didn't expect to hear her name in a place like this. Her characteristics match up with the Arfor I fought in Zero Dimension, too. But I thought we had defeated her.
I see now. I'm starting to see some connections here. This is merely speculation, but it might be possible that Arfor has deceived Esha.
Could that really be true?
My instincts tell me it's highly probable.
Then would that mean this whole issue about her body falling apart isn't true?
If Isha didn't agree with Esha's story about the failing body, then it's likely. Deception is a game Arfor is all too familiar with.
No way! So we've been tricked!
Where is Arfor currently?
She was with us moments ago, but she suddenly disappeared.
Then, in order to find out what is actually going on here, we'll need to speak with both Esha and Isha one more time. Could you two guide us to where they are?
Yes, we'll lead the way. Let's go and find the truth together.
Jump!
wonder what's inside.
Bottles, popping bottles.